Bring it in. Keep coming. Oh, time for an upgrade. Radar presto.
Say, these are nice.
Stunning.
On you go.
Good morning and welcome to the International 2014 WFTDA Division II Playoffs in Kitchener, Ontario, Canada. My name is Bam Bam and I am joined by Double H.
We have the number 8 seed going up against the number 6 seed right now. These are two bouts that I think both of these teams didn't expect to play. Demolition City Roller Derby, the Dynamite Dolls, are ranked 60 in the WFTDA overall. They came into this tournament the number 8 seed, and they went down with a really knockdown fight against Bear City in game number 1. They lost by 3 points there. They have a record of 2-3 on the year in sanctioned play, and they're going to be taking on Boulder County's All-Stars. Boulder County, the number 6 seed coming into this tournament. They're ranked 54th in the WFTDA, and they have a 5-1 record in sanctioned play, so a little bit better, but we're going to see if both of these seeds kind of work out in terms of rankings. Going against one each other, we will talk about team number 1, and that is going to be Demolition City, if you'd like to read that roster for us, Bam Bam.
It would be my pleasure. Skating number 0 is Hertz Donut, 0-0 is B-Don Kadonk, 11-0-9 Tenacious V, 21 is Coco Cremaho, 22 Bangs McCoy, 25 Lickety Splint, 44 Steel Stitches, 51 Sprintin' Tarantino, 71 I'm a Ho Killer, 75 Shelby N. Payne, 81 Steffery, 82 Godzilla, 911 4 Alarm Felon, and No H8 Flex Abel.
No hate.
No hate here?
You can't hate. Number 0717, Catapult for Boulder County Bombers. Number 11, Trixie Von Tees. Number 117, Mussolini. Number 151, Smash-a-Lotopus. Number 204, Genitalia. Number 451, Dynafire. Number 5, Misfortune Cookie. Number 666, Short Stack. Number 717, Hershey Bad. Number 727, Janesaurus Jukes. Number 818, Feisty One. Number 88, Catastrophe B. Number A1, Sauce. And number M16, Meg My Day.
Your skating officials for this go-around will be 2D Tin Whistle, Penny Whistler, Julius Seizure, Ref Fried Beans, Bonies Adams, Del From Hell, Just Mo, and Cleveland.
It took you a minute to not laugh at that one,
well,
didn't it, Bam Bam?
You know, I like a good name just like we all do. Want to thank you again for joining us on WFTDA.tv for our second Division II playoff, brought to you in part with the Tri-City Roller Derby Organization and, of course, the Women's Flat Track Derby Association.
On the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line for Boulder, Feisty One, and for the Dynamite Dolls, that is Sprint and Tarantino.
As we have our first whistle underway, it looks like the jammer for the team in white. Again, that is the
Boulder, that is Feisty One.
Yeah. She's being sent to the penalty box, a cut on the immediate interior. That means that we've got the Dynamite Dolls jammer coming through. That is going to be 51, Sprint and Tarantino, looking to see which way she will enter the pack. As you can see, she was moving a little bit slowly. She's got one or two to spin around.
And she's going to get that cutting penalty. That was an interesting three-wall, very slow-motion brace at the front of the pack there, sending her off. And now we are going to wait for Boulder's Jammer to be released. That's Feisty One coming back out of the penalty box, Bam.
Pack moving back forward now. Feisty One looking for which way she'll go. She's got that four-wall to get around. A little bit of rotation now, switching out to a bridge. Switching back to that three, last-minute push, not quite able to contain her. That is her initial pass.
But she is the only jammer currently scoring points right now, so she has a chance to draw first blood here for Boulder, which she does by getting her hips in front at the back of the pack.
Got three more to get around now, too. Nice back and forth. We've got the team captain who's playing pivot out there for Demolition City, holding again on the second round. That point, though, going to start to accrue 5 points. First up on the board, Boulder County.
Big hit at the front of the pack from Catastrophebe. It does not hold Dynamite's jammer back, though. She's also through for 5 points. No lead jammer here, Bam, so we do have the full 2 minutes.
Well, not a whole lot of time left in this first jam, so we'll see if there's any opportunity for the jammer for Demolition City to get out any points. Got to make that pass. Gets pushed to the outside, has to reset herself. Looks like there will be not enough time, so points going to be definitely favoring Boulder City. We'll see how many more. Just enough time to get another pass in.
That's Lickety Splint and Steffery that just went to the penalty box for Demolition City. We do have a score now of Boulder 14, Demolition City 8. 27 minutes and 45 seconds left to go in the first period. That is Miss Fortune Cookie on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line for Boulder, and Godzilla for Dynamite Dolls.
Miss Fortune Cookie taking just a bit of a lean over the back of Godzilla, able to pay off, takes that interior lane. She's got one to get in front of. That is the pivot, Shelby and Payne for the Dynamite Dolls. She gets around, she is lead jammer.
That was a huge pack advantage there for Boulder right off that line. They had 4-1, and now we have some blockers back in action for the Dynamite Dolls.
Jammer's through for the Dynamite Dolls. Godzilla got a lot of track to make up for, as we now have Miss Fortune Cookie through for 4 points, getting the cold from her bench tank, call it, and she does indeed. It seems to take a minute for it to take effect, however. I thought I saw the call off, thought I heard the whistles, but the action still goes. 2 points for Dynamite.
Well, as we've seen here this weekend, there has been a little bit of psychic announcing going on. I'm not sure why that happens, but we'd like to take a moment to thank Adam Wheels. AdamWheels.com is where you want to go to learn more about Jackson. Skate for the love of it, Jackson Skates.
On the Fast Girl Skates jam line, you will see Hertz Donut, number 0, in black for Demolition City. She is up against Meg My Day for Boulder County. She's got one to pass. She is able to do so. Meg My Day is the lead jammer.
So we've got 3-on-3 pack advantage to neither jammer. We have both jammers coming through now on a scoring pass, and there's a back block call being assessed to Boulder's jammer. That is Meg My Day going to the penalty box now, Bam.
So this will go for 2 minutes. Jammer is through for Demolition City. Hertz Donut very easily able to get through. I think, again, just had the right speed, right angle. She's able to pick up 5 points passing around.
Score now, Boulder 18, Demolition City 15, but Demolition City's jammer coming through. That is Hertz Donut for 5 points, Bam.
Pack just holding still right now. You consider you've got 3-3, one piece in the penalty box. Slow movement, but it gets them going. Nice little bit of a train line, opens up that interior. 5 more points now for Demolition City as they go up 25 to Boulder's 18.
Hertz Donut is on a 15-point pass. She's going to try to make it a 20 as we started that with a power jam. Now we do have Meg My Day back in the action.
Trying to see what she can do. She takes a step over the line, has to come all the way back. Nice awareness from one of the blockers. Did not see who it was because she moved so quickly back to get in position to make the jammer back all the way up. She now takes a knee and gets back up. Looks like jammer is through once again. Blocker from out of nowhere. Nice move from Steffery for Demolition City. Holds back the jammer successfully, allows her own jammer to get through. That's another 5 points for Boulder.
Shelby Payne headed to the penalty box, sitting there now, actually, the notorious RED penalty box for an out-of-play call that she did not look very happy about, Bam.
Excuse me, on that last call, that was Hertz Donut for Demolition City, who was able to pick up that 5 points. That's just how much action is going on today. You can't. They're wearing white and black. I don't know how I can't keep track of them, but we're going to do our best as we continue. Demolition City 31, Boulder County 23.
And that jam represented a huge lead change, a big shift, 21 points in that jam for Hertz Donut. So a big, big jam for Demolition City. We'll see what they can do in the next jam. That's Smash-a-Lotopus on the Fast Girl Skate start line here against Sprint and Tarantino.
Get underway. Starting to move a little bit slowly, trying to find their lane. Smash-a-Lotopus looking at the interior, decides that she's got to go all the way to the outside, and unfortunately draws the cutting the track penalty in the process. Though it looked like a moment, referee was calling it was her, is that she was just pacing on the interior with Sprint and Tarantino, who is lead jammer, now looking for some pack action.
This is a big opportunity for Demolition City to push forth on those points. Their last jam out, they scored 21 because of a power jam, and now we have a 5-point pass from Sprint and Tarantino.
Interesting, it looks like we have got the referee waving the jammer back in, the Smash-a-Lotopus for Boulder County. Not exactly sure what has gone on, but we may get some clarification. We'll let you know. But she is now back on the track at the back of the pack. She is being recycled currently as the jammer for Demolition City is taking advantage right now. Sprint and Tarantino picks up yet another 5 points for their team.
So they're sitting on 10 points. They've scored 31 points in the last two jams, this one included. That is all due to two power jams in a row. Oh, and there's going to be the cut call, Bam.
Sprint and Tarantino comes through, tries to call it off, but unfortunately her momentum coming back in carried her back into legal play, which actually then results in her committing the cut. She's not able to call it off before that happens.
So we are 3-on-3 power jam advantage now for Boulder City. That was a 5-point pass the last time out here for Smash-a-Lotopus.
She's able to do that once again as she comes around on that outside, keeps her skates inbounds. Beans has his full finger extended, including the thumb. That's going to be 5 more points. They're trying to catch up right now. Boulder County at 33, Demolition City at 41. There's a little bit of time left. The jammer is out of the box for Demolition City, but I don't think that Sprint and Tarantino may have enough time. Oh, if anybody's going to correct me, it's going to be a quality jammer like she. She's able to get up there in time and actually get all 4 points once again, effectively proving me wrong.
Well, we are looking at 10 points for Boulder City in the last jam, 14 for Demolition City, and before that, we had a 21-point jam for Demolition City, so two big back-to-back jams for Demolition City, but Boulder able to capitalize on a power jam of their own right now on the Fast Girl Skate start line. Feisty one for Boulder, and Godzilla for Demolition City.
Godzilla, the small one, ironically, at the back of the pack, trying to push her way up now into the middle. Jammer getting pushed on the outside for Boulder, looking to see which way she can go. Feisty one now at the back of the pack, trying to move. As you can see, a lot of tension. There's not a lot of room for people to move around. Nice move there. Pivot gets in the way of Demolition City's Jammer, being able to slow that down. So Sauce, good work, frees up some time. Boulder County's Jammer out, lead Jammer.
But right behind her, Godzilla. On a scoring run now is Feisty One. Oh, huge knock to the inside between turns 3 and 4. I don't know if that was a hit to the head, but it looked like her neck snapped back pretty far. No call on that. She looks a little bit dazed headed off to her bench, Bam.
Well, what was interesting is also pretty much the entire pack of Demolition City was quickly pointing in a forward motion either to their bench or something about the motion. So something certainly happened. So if it was, you know, didn't really impact the gameplay and they thought it did, referee's discretion call says no. So we continue to move forward as we look at the Fast Girl Skate start line. Jamming Miss Fortune Cookie in white, Hertz Donut in black.
And there's panties flying everywhere. It looked like a pivot. It looked like there might have been two pivots fielded. I know, panties flying everywhere. It's roller derby, right?
It is. It looks exactly. There was clarification, so one of the helmet covers comes off. But it looked like actually in both cases, because we have also outside, you can't quite see it, but outside of the skating zone, there's another helmet cover. So it looks like there was a pivot issue in both cases. Either way, a little bit of confusion here. Now we're trying to figure out how many points are going to go up. Demolition City picking up 4 points on that pass around.
All right, so the score now, Demolition City 49, Boulder 36. The WFTDA would like to thank Rydell Skates. RydellSkates.com is where you can go for more information. The Blue Streak by Rydell, raw power, just add skater.
Short stack up against Brent and Tarantino on the fast girl skates. Start line, both of them move very quickly. Sprint Tarantino takes that interior lane, goes up into the middle. Seems to be a popular strategy with this team, and it certainly pays off. A little bit of a bump spin at the last moment. She gets around to become lead jammer. Meanwhile, jammer for Boulder, looking to see if she has any opportunity. She does not, because unfortunately she goes a little bit too far outside, drawing the cutting the track penalty, being sent to the notorious RED penalty box.
Demolition City doing such a good job defensively. They did start with the advantage off the line with four, and they really extended nicely all the way out, forcing Boulder County's jammer all the way out and to the penalty box. Another 5 points there, though, for Demolition City.
Nice work happening in the pack. You know, holding that blockade is not just for jammers. Good work pushing the opposing blocker out as Demolition City is able to reset, get a little bit of clarity. Opportunity for their jammer to get through. She has a bit of a push at the last bit, but she does pick up 5 more points. The Sprint and Tarantino is going to take the total point. 64 right now for Demolition City. Looking to get a few more. Lots of time left. Boulder County at 36. Their jammer is back in. We'll see what short stack can do about it, though.
So 3-on-3 there. Demolition City did a really good job offensively. There was a nice 3-wall that Boulder had put up. But it was really put asunder pretty quickly by just a quick burst of offense there. We're looking at a score. Oh, we're looking at a Boulder timeout. A score Boulder 36. Demolition City is 64. And that last jam, bam, was a 15-point jam. So Demolition able to put up some significant points in the last 4 or 5 jams. There was one scoreless jam for them. That was jam 5. But beyond that, we're looking jam number 3, 21 points. Jam 4, 14. Jam 7, 15. So really, it's these big jams that are putting them up at this differential here.
Well, it seems like they're really able to take opportunities when they find them and make them when they don't. So you've had 2 times that the jammer's gone to the penalty box. Points have gone up in favor of Demolition City. They're really able to get momentum when they need to, and those short little bursts, I think, are why we're seeing the point difference right now of about 28, if I'm not mistaken.
All right, we are looking at just under 18 minutes at 17 minutes and 57 seconds. And yes, thank you, Keeper of the Skate, Boulder County. We will say it with you, Boulder County. If you'd like to say more to us, go to Talk2WFTDA, use that hashtag on Twitter, bam.
Off the fast girl skates start line, you've got Godzilla in the black skating against, you know, everyone, but Meg My Day in particular for Boulder in the white. Boulder's jammer gets knocked to the interior. Meg My Day gets pushed back, but she is not far behind Godzilla because the same thing happened to her. So they just more or less reset with a little bit more momentum. The jammer has been established for Godzilla, but I think that she just made a bit of a mistake. That was it. She got knocked out. Her skates were inbound. When she stood up to right herself, she put herself back inbound position, drawing the cutting the track.
So this is a power jam now for Boulder County. We will say it again, Boulder County. Beautiful work here in the pack as well from Demolition City. They are at the pack advantage despite this power jam, bam.
Boulder City's jammer gets pushed inside the pack. She's got a 3-wall to get around, bumping with 2 as a bridge has now broken off to just 1. Pivot realized she's got to stop back. Last blocker, I believe that was Sauce trying to insinuate that face contact had been made. Referee did not see it. If it did indeed happen, jammer continues to go through, picking up points in the meanwhile.
So now we are 4-on-4 for defenders. Oh, nope, I spoke too soon. We are 4-on-3 pack advantage to Boulder County. They have a beautiful 4-wall in the back there, holding back Godzilla.
But not to be outdone, we've got the jammer being held by Demolition City. That was 2 now again, breaking off to a 1. You've got to stretch that bridge out, making sure you don't pass that zone of engagement. She's able to do so, and again, just nice movement. You see her arms are down. And that's the point at which she's got to let her up.
You know what? Steffery did such a beautiful job at the front there for Demolition, really holding back Meg My Day. And she did it slowly and methodically. And that's what you want to do to trap those jammers. Meanwhile, Godzilla threw for an additional. Oh, that is her initial pass, actually.
Yeah, Genitalia tried to get a little bit of a bump on her on the last bit. Could not hold Godzilla. You can see a little bit of tiredness, you know, heavier breathing, certainly, and it's very understandable. She's able to get just enough speed to not make it in, unfortunately, as the jab is concluding. Sorry.
Did you just say heavy breathing was understandable?
In almost every case, heavy breathing is understandable.
That's the new slogan, roller derby, colon. Heavy breathing is understandable.
I had better copyright that right now. Hashtag heavy breathing.
Hashtag.
Let us know what you're thinking right now. Hashtag KW awesome. And also, of course, the ubiquitous talk to WFTDA. Official timeout right now as our referees are having a conversation in the middle. Looks like our NSOs also getting in probably just a corroboration of scores, points.
But getting ready on the Fast Girl Skate start line is Smash a Lotopus for Boulder County, and we're looking at Hertz Donut for Demolition City. We would love to thank Fast Girl Skates. They are one of our sponsors. Check them out at fastgirlskates.com. Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship@fastgirlskates.com.
2D10 whistle ahead, referee having a quick conversation with both of the benches. Curious as to what that is about. Hopefully we'll be able to find out shortly, but it looks like he's just maybe clarifying some points. Showing him his whistle. It's new, apparently. It's a fox.
So one thing that we failed to mention that's extremely important, Demolition City is the host of one of our Division I playoffs this year in Evansville. And that is going to be a hugely fun time. I will be there. I am hoping if you can't make it, you'll join us on WFTDA.tv.
I know I will.
I know you will. And it'll be a great time.
It absolutely will. Of course, that is our second set. We have four Division I playoffs. We are now on the second day of our second set of Division II playoffs here in Kitchener-Waterloo, Ontario, Canada. Our good friend's going to give us some corroboration. But as we look right now, looking forward, Hertz Donut off the Fast Girl Skates start line, looking to see if she can get out in front before Smash a Lotopus is able to. There's a little bit of a struggle right now to see who the first one will be. And finger is pointed at Demolition City. That is lead jammer Hertz Donut.
Shelby in pain, huge hit to the inside for her team. Great defensive work on the inside for Demolition City. Boulder County still able to get through. That's her initial pass there for Smash a Lotopus. That's a 4-point pass there, though, for Hertz Donut. And really good work here defensively by Boulder County. I'm looking at the number of points. The last three jams, they've been able to hold Demolition City to only 4 points while scoring 10 of their own.
Yeah, looking quickly at the penalties, I think we're seeing Demolition City a little bit more players going, but it's spread out. They've only gone once, possibly twice, where it seems like we have repeat offenders for Boulder County, and I think that's, again, one of the contributing factors as to why our score is now Boulder County 46, Demolition City 68 with 15 to go.
Feisty 1 and Sprint and Tarantino off the Fast Girl Skate start line. Through for lead jammer right now, Feisty 1.
Again, moving slowly, setting her pace. Pack had already moved back her assistants, really focused defensively right now, letting know that they don't need to work offensively because they're going to allow the jammer to do that. Looks like
that is a forearm call being assessed to Sprint and Tarantino.
So we now have a power jam as well as 5 points happening. Boulder City trying to make a little bit of a run of it. They need to catch up as they trail by 17 points.
Boulder City has kind of an interesting formation. They've got like a three wall plus one. I think you called that out earlier in the tournament, fam. Three plus one, but it's working out for them nicely. They've got that three wall set up and that additional defender there to play offense or defense as needed. Mm-hmm.
And again, what we're finding is they're often a spotter. What you're trying to see like right here is that even if it breaks into that two plus one, now certainly forming the bridge, but looking in that, letting the people know you're focused on the jammer, as you should be, but it's good to have your ears open as well, getting that communication going. And I think we're seeing great defense at the front right there. Again, nice long bridge, but two more. They can only push it so far, and they've got to let her up.
Lickety split forced to let her go. Really great speed control from Demolition City. They're able to hold those jammers back while not getting those clockwise or out of play calls. Great work there.
And unfortunately, Sprint and Tarantino comes back in, and now she gets cutting the track penalty. Once again, she is going to go to the penalty box. 4 trips already.
Ooh, that is Bangs McCoy at the front there with Lickety Splint. And they are forced to let her go, but not before going down themselves. It's a 5-point pass for Boulder County.
And that makes it a 2-point game with about 10 seconds left, so certainly enough time for her to get through one more. We'll see if a lead change does occur. I have no doubt she has gotten past 2, if not 3. We'll see what happens, how she was in the box, and she is awarded the full complement of 5 points. Therefore, Indeed, Demolition City 68. Lead change as Boulder County goes up 71.
That was a 25-point pass, Bam. So in the last three jams, we've seen 35 points put up by Boulder County. And we've seen four put up by Demolition City. So both of these teams obviously quite capable. We do have a timeout now, a team timeout from Demolition City. I think that's a good call for them. They're going to need to rearrange the momentum here a little bit because things have swung for sure in Boulder County's favor. And I think it's in no small part to those defensive formations or offensive formations. They're really set up for success there if they're able to keep their blockers out of the notorious RED penalty box and on the track. They could use that three wall plus one. Let's call it the three plus one formation after Bam Bam here. And they're able to use that for either offense or defense. It's working out very nicely for them.
And I think, of course, you're absolutely right. But the idea that we're also seeing a shift in which jammers are going to the notorious RED penalty box. You had that little bit of a reining in from Boulder County. They were spending a little bit too much time there. And I think that you're starting to see where Demolition City sees their lead slip away. You get a little bit more aggressive, you take a little bit more risk, and therefore you're much more likely to spend time in the notorious RED penalty box. As we get lined up again, Steph Faria is going to be jamming for Demolition City. She is going up against Miss Fortune Cookie off the Fast Girls Skate start line. Got our jammers right now locked up in a bit of a scrum. Demolition City controlling the back. Nice four wall. Little bit of a hit. Oh, that was nice balance. 21 is able to stay in her toes. Keep in bounds. Jammer, though, coming through. Pivot is peeled off for the All-Stars.
And that is a cutting penalty. And we also have a jammer penalty right now that is also a cutting the track penalty for Boulder County. That is Miss Fortune Cookie, otherwise known as MF Cookie.
Steph Arena now coming up into the pack. She has got two to pass. Nice footwork. Really, really done for both offense and defense. And we've seen Genitalia do that a couple of times now. I think we'll see that probably throughout the game. She's really able to adjust her feet and move around, get into position that's, once again, Pack just holding still.
Nice.
Passive-aggressive defense.
Really nice bracing there, though. There was a bit of an aggressive offense you can see here, and that is going to be a forearm call assessed to Trixie Von Tees.
Steph Arie now sent to the notorious RED penalty box for cutting the track.
So we're trading jammer penalties here in this jam. We do have three on four. Ooh, huge push forward offensively, and there is no call as Coco Cremaho gets back up.
We've seen her make some good moves. I was talking about her just a little bit ago where she's really able to get her balance, get herself into position. She doesn't make usually those bigger plays, but she makes really important ones. Again, Jammer is on her initial pass, now looking to score. That is MF Cookie for Boulder County, seeing where she can go. Oh, holds on the toe stops, but she stays in bounds, is able to pull herself back in around Bangs McCoy.
Steffery coming back out of the penalty box, notorious RED penalty box, and she is back in action.
You see her, though, rolling fairly slowly. I don't doubt that she saw how much was going to be happening on the scoreboard, the time allotment. It almost seems like she was going through the motions, waiting until the jam was done.
Well, I think it's also one of those things when you're jamming, you want to kind of try to blend in as much as possible. And if you're jetting out of the penalty box, it's going to catch somebody out of the periphery of their eye, and they're going to turn around and look at you, which is what you don't want. But we're looking at a 10-point pass for Demolition City, a 4-point pass for Boulder County in that last jam, Bam.
Looks like we have Short Stack, I believe her second time jamming in this game so far for Boulder County. She's going up against Godzilla, who's doing very effectively so far. She's only put up 2 points, but she does a lot of work in the middle of the pack to kind of slow down her opponent, Jammer. I'm sure we have more statistical information about that. We'll talk at the half. But now Pack is picking up. Jammer's moving that much faster. Short Stack on the outside. Easier pass. It looks like she had a little bit of hesitation from Shelby and Payne, who just couldn't decide which way to move. Takes an easier pass on that, picking up 4 points.
Beautiful extension at the back by all four Boulder County blockers. Now there's that three wall plus one, and you can see the last line of defense. Great work there in the middle of the pack, and they're able to keep that pack. They're able to maintain that pack with that formation, Bam.
And I think, again, it was very good placement, exactly what you are talking about. You had blocker, she was in position, she was just waiting. That's Hershey bad. And just, and again, we talk about the idea that three wall, that focus, and there's that one last person who's got fresh eyes on it, knows which way the movement is going to be, and then can almost intuit which way that's going to go. And I think we see that illustrated very well right there.
Well, right now the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box is empty. Notorious R.E.D. gear, deodorant, smell clean, even if you play dirty. That's NotoriousRED.com. And right now we only have a couple people at larger penalties, but let's take a look at the action, Bam.
Hurts Donut. Sure does. Number zero for Demolition City. She is headed out, unfortunately, right now to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for a cutting the track penalty. That's going to give a power jam opportunity happening right now. Meg My Day. Boulder County seeing if she can do anything getting past that three wall. Now we've got that bridge forming there. A little bit of rotation. I love great positioning. Pivot knows where to move that blocker.
That was Bangs McCoy for Demolition City. Nice job not catching a counter clockwise or clockwise. I'll get it right one of these times.
It's one of those. You know, you got a 50-50 shot.
It's like I said, what was it? The backslash, and I got called out for that. That is it. Speaking of getting called out, cutting the track penalty now going to Boulder County. So we have jammer in, jammer out.
That's the way it seems to go. Someday Shelby and Payne gets a little bit of credit for that. Number 75 for Demolition City.
There is no backslash. Just keep repeating it. There is no backslash. All right, Demolition City's jammer is through. That's Hertz Donut. She is on her initial pass, and she is now scoring points.
Two-point game, by the way. Just thought I'd like to mention that. 84 points for Boulder County. Demolition City at 82. 7.5 to go, but that is going to change right now. We also have a lead change. We now go 87 for Boulder City as they are three up above their opponent. Jammer is coming back around. Hertz Donut looking to see if she can add just a little bit more to that differential as the jammer is about to come back in for Boulder County. We will see what Meg My Day can do. She's got about 27 seconds left to make anything happen, but that four wall.
So that's what's interesting. Boulder County set up with a four wall that was almost a reverse four wall. You've got three blockers lining up backwards and only one lining up in the forwards direction, and it seemed to work out for them pretty well so far. Their awareness is good. They just have to watch out for those clockwise calls or depending on where they are.
5 points. Very happy, I'm sure, Demolition City's bench is. You can hear the clacking of their wrist guards. 0 point game for Boulder.
Yeah, the score now, Boulder County 84, Demolition City 92. So many lead changes, Bam. It's like a ballroom class. I said that before.
That is solid. That's another shirt waiting to happen.
So
Boulder County. Boulder County's taking a timeout right now. Reminding you, let us know what you think. What's your new t-shirt slogan for the WFTDA? Let us know on the hashtags talk to WFTDA, KW Awesome.
I think Nicole says it best. Nicole LaBeouf on Twitter says, lead change, lead change, lead change. And that has been the name of the game at KW Awesome this past weekend. Even though we're only two games in, this is the second game into Saturday. If you're not watching it, I don't even know what to tell you. You must not like roller derby.
I know what to tell you. You spend $7 so you can actually see it. Well, I appreciate you knowing that this is the home of roller derby. You come to WFTDA.com, WFTDA.tv, because this is where roller derby lives. This is where the action happens. Thank you so much
that
for listening.
That is another t-shirt, Bam. Good job. This is where roller derby lives. Done. Next season
write
slogan.
Write it down. But for $7, you can watch the rest of this tournament. Now, it is going to be $12 for the Division One, and $20 for championship. But really, I don't think you have a valid argument the way this weekend has gone so far. Even last weekend, $7. Come on now.
And that is Smash a Lot of Puss jamming for Boulder County against Steffery. And there's a multiplayer call being assessed in the middle of the pack, and that is going to go to a skater for Boulder County.
It looks like that was Dangerous Jukes. She is going to be taking her a while to get around as she got a little bit tumbled up as the pack itself went out. Big, big drawback of the jammer. Smash a Lot of Puss buys a lot of time for Steffery to get around, but now she is caught up in the pack as initial pass has happened for Boulder County's jammer. Steffery getting through, 5 points, calls it.
Once again, the score, Boulder 84, Demolition City 97. That last jam, actually the last two jams, Boulder County not able to make any progress at all. The last two jams, Demolition City 15 points.
Well, all right.
The WFTDA would like to thank Printco Graphics. PrintcoGraphics.com is where you can go to learn more. For all your printing needs, hit up PrintcoGraphics.com.
Off the Fast Girl Skates start line, I believe that is 82 in the black for Demolition City. Godzilla, she is going against in the white, feisty one, number 815 for Boulder County. Four wall, again splitting the two. Nice bit of a hop, but again, good awareness. Feisty one has her foot on the inside, realizes she has to keep in hopping. She's got to re-enter legally. She's able to do so, but again, very quickly to her credit.
So one of the things that Boulder County is doing that I talked about is the almost the inverted of what a lot of other leagues are doing right now. Instead of having, we do have a lead jammer right now, and that is Demolition City, but instead of having the inverted triangle, theirs is going the other way.
Looks like we had some blockers take a bit of a tumble. Hershey Bad was doing effective work there, and then she got caught up. Causes a spill, but again, it was false small, doing well. Interesting to see how this is going to play out.
That's going to be a low block, and that is going to be assessed to Demolition City's jammer, Godzilla.
I was just, you know, sometimes it works out. I was just talking about her. Hershey Bad leans in at just the right time. You know, the good kind of lean in. Gets a piece of that jammer as she's able to come around, sends Godzilla to the penalty box.
A really good job drawing back that extension of the pack, but there is going to be a pack destruction call assessed over here to Boulder County's pivot. That is going to be...
That's Catastrophe.
Catastrophe B.
She's going to the notorious RED penalty box. The jammer is standing in same set box on the other side. She is now released for Demolition City. We're going to see what Godzilla can do with a little bit of time left. Not a lot, but a little bit.
Great work on those toe stops, though. Through Feisty One to get through the inside.
See how many points. Looks like 4 points for Demolition City. 13 seconds left as Jammer is getting up in for Boulder County, trying to take that interior lane. Feisty One's got to get around. Beautiful assist. She was three wall in front of her. Blocker for Demolition, I'm sorry, for Boulder, sees that, opens it up. And again, Feisty One knowing she should pull back at just the right time. Very, very good teamwork.
We are at a two-point game right now, just about over 3 minutes. That's 3 minutes, 15 seconds left in the first period. Boulder County, 103. Demolition City, 101. And we are going toe-to-toe here. The last jam, we had 19 points from Boulder County. They're trying to even the score. They actually took the lead doing that, and 4 points only from Demolition City.
We have an official review, speaking of Demolition City. 2D Tin Whistle calling in the benches, having a conversation.
So just a quick look at penalties. We do have on Boulder County, Trixie Von Tees has 5. We also have 5 from Catastrophe B. So 2 pretty important blockers for Boulder County. And then for Demolition City, the high scorers for penalties there is Britton Tarantino at 4 and Steffery at 4. So we're looking at slightly lower penalty averages here from Demolition City, but we're neck and neck right now with the number 8 and the number 6 seed.
Well, this is also where we have been more or less throughout the weekend as we're looking at overall total penalties. We see a lot of times where the teams have a smattering, a handful. There's only one or two that have a little bit higher. Right now, I think that Boulder County has 2 that are at 5, which are higher than the average. But in most cases, we're seeing a moderate amount of penalties, but it seems like an appropriate amount for that point in the game.
Yeah, you definitely don't want to go into the half with 5 penalties. That means that it's going to be a lot harder for you coming into the second penalty. That's another 30 minutes that you only are able to get one more penalty before you are fouling out. We'd like to thank Mysterio for listening to us on his drive. Hopefully he's driving someplace awesome. We'd like to hear from you as well at the hashtag Talk2WFTDA if you've got questions for us, or if you just want to talk about our new marketing slogans, please hit us up on Twitter. And the WFTDA would also like to take this opportunity to thank Rollerbones. Rollerbones.com is where you'll find info on Rollerbones. Their turbos are the wheels by which all others are measured. And in Canada, they're measured by the metric system.
Yeah, you get out your micrometer. Digital is nice, but I'm old school.
It was enjoyable driving into Canada, though, to see that suddenly the metric system is in use, and I have to remember everything that I learned in high school, which I don't remember much of.
Well, it's that call reassurance when you see it, it's like, oh, 58 miles. Oh, no, wait, that's kilometers. I'm closer.
We're so much closer than we thought.
It's so true in so many things.
And speaking of close, we're going to get a quick clarification, but we're going to take a look at the score again. Boulder County, 103. Demolition City, 101. Just over 3 minutes left in the first period. This is just the first period, man.
Well, it also, again, seems to be the tale of the weekend. In the vast majority of cases, we've had consistently close games. And it's hard to get better. it's hard to get calmer when you've got, you know, great ref crews, gate games. Lightning Slim, what have you got for us?
So Demolition City, their official review was in aid of having the low block against their jammer overturned. They were successful in doing so and therefore will retain their official review for the remainder of the period.
I actually think that was the right call. I think there, from my vantage point, which is obviously not the official's vantage point, it looked as though it was not her that initiated the impact. But I think that I trust this crew implicitly to make the right decision. And upon review, they decided that it wasn't the right decision. So I trust them.
I would love to bandwagon and say I totally agree, but I'm not going to do that. But yeah, we actually are in perfect line for that hit as the communication we're getting now is being reaffirmed. We can see where... Again, blocker leans in, makes that contact. Just because somebody goes down doesn't mean that there was negatively impactful contact being made.
And it was right in front of us on the inside lane, right between turns 4 and 1. And it's one of those things, when you're on the apex of the track, it's in some ways it's a lot easier a shot, right? Because you're jumping over an arc. But if you're trying to jump the inside line, it's a straight line, and somebody can very easily come out to hit you out, right? All you have to do is move your booty in some cases, and you can hit that jammer out. But if you're in the wrong place at the wrong time, your leg can also be trying to protect that inside line, and I'm pretty sure that's exactly what happened.
Well, you also have to consider the fact that this is very important because the jammer in particular question was marked as having now the fourth trip to the penalty box, and that's someone who's been putting up some points, has been an effective part of their total overall scheme. You need to try and give them every opportunity to stay on the track as much as possible.
So, and every opportunity to stay in the game.
Yeah, exactly the point. So I think that, you know, as you're suggesting, very well called. Good time to do so. 3 minutes left, you know, so they can still use it again if they feel appropriately the need to do.
The WFTDA would like to take a moment to thank Radar Wheels. Go to radarwheels.com to learn more about them. Radar Presto is a proud partner of the WFTDA broadcast. And if you're watching and or listening to our broadcast here on WFTDA.tv, we want to remind you that you can reach out to us via Twitter. Use the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. That's talk the number 2, WFTDA. And you can ask us all kinds of questions. Marketing questions, metric system questions.
Lightning Slim will be our
Lightning Slim will
that.
Help us with that.
It's very, very useful.
Questions about this game. It is a 2-point game now. We're going to remind you, Boulder County 103, Demolition City 101. This is just the first period. We have a whole other period to play after this. And it's 3 minutes left in the first period. The winner of this game... we'll move on to play Queen City in Game 11 later this evening at 6 o'clock Eastern Daylight Time.
And reminding you, if you're like me, your attention span has a tendency to wander, as I did grow up in the 80s and 90s in America. It's very easy while you're on the website to go and check out previous tournament merchandise. You can always go over to WFTDA.com/store. You can get your tournament merchandise there. But also, they have retro merchandise. If you were at a tournament last year and forgot to get a shirt, you can pick one up, and there are discounts on a lot of previous merchandise. So not only are there tournaments this year you can dress for success for, but last year too, so you can sit at home and reminisce while you're listening to WFTDA.tv.
Let's also take a second to talk about the rest of the games coming up. The one that I think is probably most anticipated for the weekend right now is Bear City versus Kalamazoo, and that is coming up next. That's game number 9 at 2 p.m., and that is going to be extremely contentious. Bear City coming into this tournament, the number 9 seed, upsetting the skaters you're seeing on the track right here, the number 8 seed, Demolition City. And they went on to win over DC Roller Girls in game 4 by just 10 points. DC Roller Girls, I'll remind you right now, they were the number 1 seed coming into the tournament. So if you want to talk Cinderella story, I think Bear City is the team to talk about. They are going to be taking on Kalamazoo, the Kalamazoo Derby Darlings out of Kalamazoo, Michigan, who hosted Division 2 playoffs last year. And coincidentally had some of the best donuts I have ever tried in my life. Lightning Slim is laughing at me because he agrees. He was also there. So big games coming up today. Also, Riddle taking on Gold Coast, the evening game at 8 o'clock. That is going to be contentious. We're going to see which one of these teams, Bear City, Kalamazoo, Rideau, Gold Coast, are going to go to Nashville. So these games have huge stakes to them.
Well, in theory, these two, well, not in theory, in application, two of these teams will go. Will go on because, of course, the next game, Bear City versus Kalamazoo, is going to put them in the championship game. Rideau and Gold Coast, same thing. So two of those four teams will go on, and there is a bit of interest when you consider that this could be two international teams going to play at championship for the first time. So very exciting from that perspective as well.
And it would be fitting at the WFTDA's first internationally located tournament here in Kitchener-Waterloo, Canada, in Ontario. And I have to say, the food here has also been just as fantastic as last year's Division II playoffs. I just had some type of fritter. It was amazing. Yes, Department of Skate wants to talk to us about how amazing D2 playoffs have been. And also, we made strawberry tarts. Good work.
Feel free to send them to us, care of Lightning Slim, P.O. Box.
Canada. All right, so we are still having a conversation out here, I believe, about this low block being overturned. So this is going to take a few minutes for them to sort out. But again, we're having some conversation here on Twitter and also talking about the lineup for this evening.
Yeah, of course. As always, let us know what you're thinking, what your analysis of the reffing has been so far. Remember, be kind. Hashtag talk to WFTDA. Hashtag longest official review ever. That is not true. I think the
hashtag
longest is
great marketing ideas.
Is about 12, 13 minutes. So we're far from that at this point. But again, it's all about that consistent communication. As we understand, these games have been exceedingly tight. You're talking about a two-point game right now. You have to get everything right, as our referees, of course, understand. Our NSOs are very aware of. They have to take everything as seriously as necessary. They also need to be able to hear the captain's complaints, concerns, and make sure that they're addressed and there's understanding. And it looks like we are just about finishing up with it right now because everybody seems to have an accord. We're going to get back to our action as the whistle will indicate right about here.
So we're actually speculating that this might have taken longer because they're trying to assess out if there were points that should have been awarded because of that low block call. So we're going to take a look in a minute. But we'd like to also take a minute to thank S1 Helmets, a proud partner of the WFTDA. S1Helmets.com is where you want to go for more information there. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad. What?
What?
What? Yeah. We just did that. All right, Lightning Slim is going to let us know what the verdict was.
Well, folks, as we suspected, this second official review concerned the points scored in that jam and the implications of the penalty being overturned. And the no score, the lack of score that was put up at the end of that jam, that will remain as it was ascertained that the jammer's skates did not touch ground before the end of the whistles.
All right. So when she did land, she did not land with both skates touching, as you are supposed to do if you want to get those points. Bam, we do have Misfortune Cookie jamming for Boulder County and Stefferie for Demolition City.
Yeah, I agree with that call. I think that's exactly what happened from our perspective. But we'll see what Stefferie can do to make up for that difference right now as she is out there getting around with a nice little bit of a hip touch on the opponent blocker. Lets her become lead jammer, though, in hot pursuit right on her heels. That is MS Cookie.
We do have 4-on-3 now, 4-on-4 in those blockers. So everybody on the track right now, Bam.
It's kind of nice to see. Whistles right there. 1 point for Demolition City, so that is going to bring them ever closer. That's what we like to call a one-point game. Boulder 103, Demolition 102. 2 minutes, 15 seconds left. So again, statistically speaking, very likely we'll get two more jams. So plenty of opportunity for someone to make that big play. We've seen a couple of them, but usually they have been at the cost of one team or the other. Therefore, it's been a detrimental move in as far as going to the penalty box, making some sort of commonplace, certainly mistake, but capitalization is what both of these teams have been able to successfully do, more so for Demolition City.
Boulder County doing a heavy amount of backwards blocking, which is working out in their favor right now. And it's definitely something that Godzilla is working hard at the front. It was the back of the pack, but now she pushed her way all the way to the front.
And Smash a Lot Puss trying to see if she can reverse that, as it looks like you've got that three wall plus one, trying to move around to the front to see that last line and maybe open up an opportunity for her own Gemma to come through. Doesn't look like she's able to get there in time. So again, we've broken back off where you've got white controlling the front, black controlling the back, three walls apiece.
Sauce looking to do some off. Ooh, beautiful hip check there to the inside. And that was not Sauce. That was actually, no, that was Sauce on the inside. I'm sorry, was that Jeans or is Jukes?
Well, she looks like she will be going to the notorious RED penalty box quite possibly because of that. But sometimes that's what you need to do. You need to draw that foul.
And she is sitting at five penalties now. And that, speaking of penalties, going to the notorious RED penalty box for a cutting the track penalty. This is Smash-a-Lotipus for Boulder County.
That is her second trip, but it looks like both times it was wearing the Jam Star. The Jammer Star is going to be now solely on the track. Brought to you by Godzilla, who's put 10 points up on the board. She's only had one trip herself, but it looks like she is going to be swapping out right now with Shelby N. Payne, the pivot. Not a whole lot of time left, but enough time. It looks like there's got about 2 seconds ahead on the jam clock, so this will actually be our last jam of the half.
And we are 4-on-4, so it is going to be a fast pack now. Boulder County takes off, setting the pace a little bit faster, trying to make it harder for the opposing jammer to score points. Now we do have everybody out of the notorious RED penalty box. That is a 5-point pass for Demolition City.
Just about zero time left. You're going to hear whistles any moment, and indeed you do. Looks like a multiplayer block, though, being assessed to number 5, Lickety Splint. So it's, she is going to start the second half in the penalty box when we come back, because we are indeed at halftime.
So the last two jams, Boulder County unable to put points on the board. The last two jams, Demolition City able to put 6, and that has put them in the lead. Right now, Demolition City 107, Boulder County 103. And take a look at this, Bam Bam. One thing that has happened in this game that has rarely happened this weekend, and actually in the playoffs at all, mm-hmm. is the use of timeouts.
Yeah.
Boulder County already down 2. Demolition City burned their official review for this period and one of their timeouts. So that's something that we haven't actually seen this season. I think we remarked earlier at ECDX that there were a lot of games there that barely used any timeouts or official reviews. So definitely a smart tool for both of these teams.
Well, and I think one of the differences you'll see is it depends. Is it a fast game or a slow game? I think when you have a fast game, a lot of fast action, people just want to keep that momentum going. Where I think this is one of those games that's a great example of taking those short movements, taking that slower action, and you need to take a little bit of time to reassess because you're not getting those big bursts, those big pushes. As we've seen pretty much throughout the score, slowly inching up right next to each other. It's like, you know, cousins getting measured every time. One's a little higher. Now it's the next one. Now it's the next one.
More marketing slogans. One thing I did want to point out that I think Boulder County is doing extremely well is they have sort of an inverted triangle defense, and what that brace is setting them up to do, instead of having those two blockers in the back and that one brace at the tip of the triangle, they've inverted that, and it's actually worked out for them in spots, because when the offense is in front of them and tries to come back, then the offense risks getting a back block call if they push those turned around skaters. So something to watch out for in the second period. We're going to take a break to thank some of our very gracious sponsors who have really done a tremendous job. We couldn't do these broadcasts without them, so we'd like to thank them very much. We'll be back for the second period in just a few minutes.
My name is Brenda Gold, and I've been at Rydell for 36 years almost. Everything is done by hand, basically. Just a one pair actually going through at a time then. And some of them are multiple colors where it'll have 5-6 colors, metallics, the different colored full grains. You name it. Some of them are pretty wild. To me, the skaters are really important because that's what keeps us going here. It's the consumer or the skater that decides, okay, is it good enough for me or not? We want them to be happy, that's for sure.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
Yeah. St. Louis Gatekeepers.
Bellstar, Rose City Rollers.
Erkin Martin, Denver Roller Dolls.
Gimme Mission, Atlanta Roller Girls.
Meow Mix, Jacksonville Roller Girls.
Kiki Your Ass from Pikes Peak Derby Dames.
Shane Bauer, St. Louis Gatekeepers.
I trust.
I skate.
I am.
I am. Noah Derby.
Are you the Jammer Assist?
Why do you ask?
You sure smell offensive!
Notorious Sports Gear Deodorant, because Fritos is not a cologne.
Now I know why it's called a penalty box.
Hi!
Notorious Sports Gear Deodorant!
Take the hint!
Just a four-point game, and one of the statistics that we learned during the half was there were only 8 jammer call-offs in this game so far in 17 jams. That's substantial.
Well, and I think when you contribute part of that to the fact that very often it was the lead jammer, it was sent to the penalty box, so it really negates the opportunity for it to be called off. So therefore, you just have to skate that much harder, that much longer.
And of course, the first half, back and forth, pretty evenly matched with both of these teams. Demolition City coming into this tournament, the number 8 seed, and that is Boulder County coming in, the number 6 seed. All of these games have been amazing and heartbreaking and wonderful and gut-wrenching. And right now they're down to 4 points. Demolition City, of course, lost game number 1 by just 3 points to Bear City, who advances to game number 9 next to play Kalamazoo. So just a few points mean huge, huge stakes here in Kitchener-Waterloo.
It's very possible that we can have a few more upsets. I mean, we certainly had 2 rather large ones. Some would even say 3. I mean, you've got Bear City coming in, moving as they do onto the next game, which then if they win that, they're going to be into the championship game for this division playoff. But I think that there's been a number of times in which it was no certain way to go. I mean, certainly the Rideau Valley game, people felt very strongly that they were going to come out victorious. A good game was put up on both sides, but again, that was the outcome there. But as we move forward, I think that we're going to see a lot of continuing tight games, tight gameplay. There's a lot on the line. The opportunity to not only go to the championship tournament, but again, you're advancing your ranking. You're trying to get to the point where you can push yourself into Division I.
And we do have the winner of this game moving on to game 11. That is going to be taking on Queen City. This is for the chance to get to the 5th place game. So the highest that this number 6 or number 8 seed team can reach in this tournament right now is 5th place. And of course, warming up on the track before this, as you saw coming in from the half, although they just left, that is Bear City and Kalamazoo. These two teams are going neck and neck. Kalamazoo coming in seed 4. Bear City, potentially the Cinderella story of the tournament, coming in the number 9 seed. They, of course, upset Demolition City by 3 points to get where they are, and also upset DC Roller Girls, the number 1 seed in game 4, by just 10 points. So every single point in this tournament counts.
Well, an interesting thing that I was talking about earlier with Plastic Patrick was the fact that you've got a lot of people who, of course, are excited for international play. It's good to see a team that you may not be as familiar with. So there's a lot of people here, a lot of people certainly out in the Derbyverse that are really excited about Bear City. They want to see them move forward. They want to see them progress. But you also keep in mind that they're going up against Kalamazoo, who undoubtedly wants it every bit as bad, are looking to persevere. And when you think, yeah, if they weren't playing them, they may feel the same way. Who doesn't want to see the new team or the underdog team or the perceived go ahead? But Kalamazoo is going to want it every bit as bad as Bear City. And when you think, you look, Kalamazoo, their play is a little bit more spread out amongst the team, where Bear City has relied exceedingly heavily on Master Blaster, who, I mean, already we're 2 games into the second day, still is probably the shoe-in choice for MVP at this point.
We will see. That is Feisty One jamming for Boulder County, and Sprint and Tarantino off the Fast Girl Skates start line.
2 more to get past for Feisty One as she's trying to get around. She's at the apex. She's able to use that a little bit to her advantage, but it looks like indeed a block too far for the pivot. She is going to be sent to the penalty box. That is
Shelby Payne. Yeah. She is the captain here for Demolition City.
And that is her fourth time to the notorious RED penalty box. But and something to be aware of.
That is a penalty assessed to Sprint Tarantino. I didn't see if it was a forearm call. It was a cutting call.
Well, this is going to give a power jam to Boulder County. Not able to do a lot with it right now as their jammer is being recycled. She's back into the pack right now, trying to get past the last one. Stretched out to 20 feet, but so not past it.
That was a beautiful strategy for Boulder County's offensively. That entire four wall pulled back, and they just sat, allowing a wall to get opened up. That is a block to the head, though, sending Feisty One to the penalty box, so she did not make it pass cleanly. Now out of the box, Sprint Tarantino.
Very interesting look on the face, though, of Steffery, who was the blocker there. She almost looked like, oh, you've got to be kidding me, and then realized, oh, wait, it wasn't on me. There was a little bit of relief and winning happening right there as we have our jammer in there now. Sprint Tarantino seeing which way she may be able to progress. It looks like the only way out is through, going right up the middle, getting almost out, and then nice bit of work at the last possible moment. Catastrophe holds her up, gets a lot of help at that point. Now they all tumble to the exterior. She's ready to regroup once again.
Catastrophe narrowly averting a clockwise block call there. That is one thing that Boulder County's blockers have to be wary of. A lot of this backwards blocking, a lot of this backwards movement is putting you in danger for those types of calls. And we do have a score of Boulder County. Oh, the score is changing, 107 to 112 Demolition City. And so that was 4 points for Boulder County and five for Demolition City in that last jam.
So again, it is a five-point game. We're just getting back into our second half. Off the Fast Girls Skate start line in just a moment, you are going to see Godzilla number 82 in the black for Demolition City. She will be against Smashalotopus number 151 in the white for Boulder County. Whistle has us underway. Both jammers starting about midpoint, though a little bit of a run-up. Godzilla trying to go for some speed. Again, it doesn't necessarily work for you, I think.
Godzilla narrowly escaping that cutting call on turn one, is through to become lead jammer for Demolition City.
Jammer is out now. Smashalotopus on her initial pass, got through, points scored very quickly. Demolition City calls it off. We saw this happen before. I think we may see a little bit more of this happen now. Get those points, call it.
The other thing to think of when the score is this close is also just the strategy of point denial. You just really want to be aware of where your opposing jammer is at all times, because every point counts. On that Fast Girl Skate start line, Short Stack jamming for the first time for Boulder County against Hertz Donut for Demolition City. She's one of your favorite names of the tournament, Bam.
Yeah. It's because it's true. So we get back to it now. Wall of four controlling that front now. Three as we've got one. Again, it's that three plus one. Always in position going, and I like the 3+1 because it allows you to get in position and then also make the bridge happen.
So there was a cut on the outside from one of Demolition City's blockers trying to recycle that jammer, and that is going to be number 21, Coco Cremaho.
We do have the jammer through Boulder County, getting a little bit of adjustment of the tunic there. That is Short Stack, number 666 in white. Goes to that outside, comes rolling in. Nice and slow, but consistent play. Doesn't get any kind of back block call. It's a nice bit of power where it's not about speed. It's just about stability, and she's able to push continuously, and I think that's the smart way to enter that pack.
And she's able to tiptoe through, but gets a back block call. So this is now a power jam in favor of Demolition City.
The curse of the Bam Bambino once again kills.
I don't know how you did it. I don't know how you continue to do it, Bam Bam.
I don't know why they let me. Hurts, don't it? She is jamming. She's got two to get around. She is able to do it. I want to give, again, a shout-out to her. She bad. We're not saying her name often enough. She's got the red elbow pad. She is being very smart plays in the pack, slowing the jammer down when it's effective. Not stopping, but at the very least slowing, doing a nice job of time killing.
Ooh, beautiful hit there on the inside. There is a lot of backwards work out of Boulder County, and that helps them to increase their jammer awareness, or it has helped them. Up until this point, we are 4-on-3, though, pack advantage Demolition City with their jammer coming in.
Nice bit of a trap right there. Set up, doesn't really spring the right way, but it still becomes effective. Short Stack being recycled to the outside as 5 points picked up for Demolition City. Both jammers entering at about the same time. But again, I think you've got control more at the back. The four wall, very effective, holding back short stack.
Short stack narrowly avoiding that cutting call. That is a 4-point pass for her, though, and 1 point for Demolition City. Sometimes those jammer knockouts happen so fast on the outside, and you're using your toe stops to try to both stop yourself and then quickly push yourself back onto the track. But you have to be careful where you're pushing yourself back onto that track because you don't want to draw that cut. And sometimes it happens so quickly. That's Miss Fortune Cookie jamming for Boulder County against Sprint and Tarantino for Demolition.
Miss Fortune Cookie being sent to the back as well as Sprint and Tarantino. Takes her a little bit longer as her skate's pushed out from under her, but she's back up. Though unfortunately for her, lead jammer is being assessed to Miss Fortune Cookie, who is now looking to see where she can enter the pack. Everyone that is focused on Sprint and Tarantino, who has yet to make her first pass through. All the team of white stretched way, way back. Nice reverse bridge there, making a longer walk for Sprint and Tarantino as a 5-point pass happening for the side of Boulder County.
That is the most points one jammer has scored in the last five jams for Boulder County, BAM. So the score, Boulder County 116, Demolition City 123, and points accruing right now as we speak.
Both jammers in. Looks like the penalty box is empty. Notorious RID, everybody must smell clean enough. They're going to send it back out there. Again, four wall at the front, brought to you by Demolition City. Now the three.
That is that 3+1 strategy, BAM. You've got that three wall at the back of Boulder County, now joined by their additional blocker there. Great work, though. No pack destruction on that either. Good work there for Boulder County.
Yeah, I think everybody held right where they needed to be, appropriately so. And I think, you know, a little bit of credit goes to the pivot, making sure she was up there, catastrophe, making sure she was moving forward, pulling it all together. Jam concludes with 4 points on the side of Boulder County, taking them 120. They trail 7 points behind Demolition City.
So that was a 9-point jam for them as opposed to Demolition City's 4. Demolition City scored 4 points there, 11 points the jam before that. And on the Fast Girl Skate start line, we do have Make My Day for Boulder County and Godzilla for Demolition City. And they are at the pivot line.
No, I don't believe it.
Demolition City lining up at the pivot line. Meanwhile, Boulder County was back at the jammer line with that bridge.
Again, full control, four wall in front, four wall in back, splitting the work evenly, making their jammers push hard, but I think a little bit quicker, a little bit expedient on her feet. Number 82, Godzilla, four black, she is lead jammer. Looks like, unfortunately for her team, though, Coco Cremajo sent now to her fourth time at the Notorious RID penalty box.
The score now, Boulder County 120, Demolition City 127. Boulder County's jammer now at the front of the pack.
Two more to get past. Pivot in particular, controlling her blocker. That is
Lickety Splint.
Mm-hmm.
And now it is man on man, Bam Bam.
Yeah, I was trying to see the blocker that she was working with. I can't quite make out the number.
That is number 75.
I should, of course, know that.
Shelby and Payne.
Yep. Again, she's been very consistent at the front. Again, strong, consistent blocking. B1 position. Looking to see now. 4 points picked up for Demolition City. Going to take them now 131.
I think we're going to see a bit more aggression here from Demolition City because, as we said before, it's about point denial. That was 4 more points for Demolition City, nothing for Boulder County. And you can see that we're evening. Demolition City really advancing their lead here. Boulder County 120, and that's Demolition City 131. Just over 20 minutes left in the second period, BAM.
Fast Girl Skates start line shows us Hertz Donut. She's going up against Smash-a-Lotta-Puss, but not for very long. Hertz Donut out as lead jammer. Smash-a-Lotta-Puss now scattered pack, really pushing forward. She's able to get around. No one really lays a lot of block in front of her, but interesting whistle call. It looks like a hit to the head. Not sure. Oh, that was assessed. Wasn't sure if that was going to be to the jammer or not, but no, that was to the blocker. Short stack. She's got to be careful. She is kind of their fresh legs jammer. She's been to the penalty box twice. This will be her third time for the Notorious RID penalty box.
And we have an official timeout, so we'd like to take this opportunity to thank Adam Wheels. Jackson, skate for the love of it. Jackson skates. Go to adamwheels.com for more information.
I think that you were talking a little bit about, we're going to see a little bit more of a quick hard-hitting game, a little bit more erratic. As we mentioned at the beginning of the halftime, only eight times was this thing called off before the natural conclusion. I think we're going to see a lot more of that now, as again, jammers are not going to the penalty box near as often. A little bit more control is happening when those jammers get it. They're taking that advantage, hit it, quit it, getting those points, inching away. Demolition City right now just has had the opportunity to do that a little bit more because their jammers are getting out a little bit sooner. But not to be unsaid, Boulder City also trying to employ that strategy when they're able to do so.
Boulder County has been adopting a little bit more, I'm not going to call it risky, but definitely a bit more unorthodox strategy here with their blocking and their offense. But what I'm seeing from them is some very coordinated offense. So you saw earlier in one of these jams in this period, and certainly the period before, we had a four wall that just jumped back and sat on the opposition, allowing their jammer to get through. And they are, you can tell they're very well rehearsed. The one thing that often will get away from them is sometimes that backwards blocking is a bit of a hindrance because you can't get where you need to be if you get split apart that quickly. So we do also see a bit more of a traditional blocking style here from Demolition City. And in the first period, it definitely wasn't working in their favor, but now I believe that it has been working in the second period. So,
well, as you say, you know, how much risk is involved? I mean, the difference between a gamble and a risky gamble is how much is it going to cost you? So I think that when you assess the point that the fact you're not going to be able to assist your jammer, they can work it on their own, you're holding back, it pays off in the long run.
We're going to take a quick look at some penalties. Boulder County sitting at the top of the pack. Trixie Von Tees has six. So that's going to be a problem for them. Jainsurus Jukes has five. Catastrophebe, who is in this next lineup here as the pivot, has five as well. And Demolition City, Sprint and Tarantino, one of their key jammers, now right behind that Fast Girl Skates jammer line, also has five. So this could mean some problems if Demolition City loses a jammer or if Boulder County is losing some key blockers.
Well, when you consider the way that the jammers kind of parse out Boulder County, the bulk of the heavy lifting has come from Feisty One. She has 65 of their 120 points. But when you look over on the other side, Demolition City has two jammers really pulling it down. That's going to be Hertz Donut, who has 54. Sprint and Tarantino, who has 46. But as you mentioned, she has five trips to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box, so that may be an issue. But they have strong backup jammers in Steffery and Godzilla. They just haven't put up the same amount of points. But I have no doubt they would be able to step into that role if they were needed to.
So this is a 15-point game, the biggest differential we've had since the first period. And Lightning Slim, let's talk about this official timeout.
Boulder County was asking that Demolition City's jammer receive an illegal call-off penalty because in their estimation, she was not legally the lead jammer. However, no change was made by the referees.
All right, so that official review burned for Boulder County then. And we do have Miss Fortune Cookie on the Fast Girl Skates start line against Sprint Tarantino.
Nice bit of a low posture at the front for Boulder County, trying to get themselves in position.
Huge split on the outside line there from Miss Fortune Cookie, but she's drawn back.
But again, I want to say a lot of credit given right there to Sprint Tarantino, who once again has got to have suction cups on the tips of her toes because she held that line, leaned out, but pulled herself back into place to become lead jammer. Now she is gotten the bump. She's got to recycle herself back around. It's going to give a little bit better opportunity for Miss Fortune Cookie until we hear those fateful four whistles ending the jam.
And that is penalty number five for Steffery going to the penalty box. So she is the second Demolition City skater now to have five penalties. We are looking at Godzilla on the Fast Girl Skates start line against Feisty One, who, as you mentioned, Bam, has 65 points for Boulder County. Not too shabby.
Oh, there's quite a few teams who've been relying more heavily on certain jammers, and sometimes it pays off. It can bite you if you are not careful. We will see how it plays out with 18 minutes, 41 seconds left to go. As seems to be our usual, Boulder County, very content.
That's coming up
soon. Wow, I know. I was thinking ahead of the next game. I'm so excited for Derby this weekend. Boulder County content to control the back with their wall structure, Demolition City very happy to sit at the front. No real advantage one way or the other. As long as you have control, doesn't matter if you're in the front or the back. But when you split it up like that, no one's really going to be able to as effective as we're seeing right now with our jam. Feisty One, lead jammer, though the jammer in front of her, Godzilla, just able to get out. So now both are going to be able to make points on this pass. We will see if the jam is called before that, however.
So 4 points here. Those were the first 4 points, the first points at all scored for Boulder County as she calls it off. This is the fourth jam in a row that they have gone, actually they went scoreless for three, and now they scored 5 points there, Boulder County. So definitely cannot have scoreless jams for Boulder County. We've got 125 for them. Demolition City 138. This is a 13-point game at 17 and a half minutes left in period number two.
Well, I mean, at least the good news for Boulder County is that Demolition City isn't running away. They're just quietly tiptoeing. They are moving forward. They're spanning that distance, but it's not in great leaps and bounds. We will see if either of these jammers are able to leap and bound, as I think we've seen Meg My Day earlier. She's out there right now for Boulder County. She is up against Hertz Donut for Demolition City. Hertz Donut at the back trying to move through that four wall. Nice coordination happening, though. We have the 3+1 happening at the front. Demolition City, I think, always safe. You're in that front position. You don't want to get pushed too far. You have to have that bridge ready.
It is so exhausting to try to jam your way through a beautiful brace like this from the back of Boulder County. And their jammer also recycled to the back, so nobody threw yet. And finally, I shouldn't say that, Hertz Donut finally threw to become lead jammer for Demolition City.
It's almost like they do it to prove us wrong.
Truth.
As long as they do it, that's what keeps the fans happy. All of us are very excited to see 16 and a half minutes left to play. Lots of time, lots of action to come. We'll see if we can get some more of that from the jammer right now. Meg My Day, who's got that 3-2. Finally, one more. That is the pivot. If she can get past, and she does. Not able to hold her. Lickety Splint has to let her go.
Meg My Day had her work cut out for her there. I think Demolition City doing a fantastic job with that one-on-one action. And that is one thing defensively that they've done extremely well in this game. Their one-on-one backwards blocking is outstanding. And Bex Young says, I have a newfound appreciation for the skill level of all these ladies now that I am in DC Roller Girls boot camp. Really cool. We agree. The skill level is pretty outrageous here in Kitchener-Waterloo.
We get back to our Fast Girl Skates start line. Sprint and Tarantino 51 in the black. Smashalotopus 151 in the white.
Smashalotopus has 10 points already in this game for Boulder County.
Sprint and Tarantino, though, a few more. She's got 49. She's going to see if she can add some to that. She's on that interior trying to keep her skates. Oh, she's got to stay down. I think she's aware. There you go. Putting her feet back in.
That is going to be an elbow call assessed to the captain for Demolition City. That is Shelby in pain. That's going to be her sixth penalty, Bam.
Well, she's been exceedingly effective, and I think that she will be felt as a loss to this team if she cannot contain that last one. We have lead jammer. That is Smashalotopus. Coming around, she fought very hard, and she earned every second of that.
Lickety Splint headed to the penalty box, Notorious R.E.D. penalty box as well. So now just two blockers out there to fight with for Boulder County.
Nice move from Steffery. Good in many positions. A great utility player. Nice bit of a bump. Forces the jammer out. Smashalotopus has to come back.
And there's that fantastic bracing again from Boulder County. Forcing out Demolition City's jammer.
It's again Steffery at that front. That last line. But we'll see. Smashalotopus stretching it to a bridge too far, almost, but she gets the spin move, so she earns it herself. 5-point pass, Smashalotopus.
So the difficulty there with the one-on-one is getting forced to the outside or the inside. You only want to go so far because you don't want that opposing blocker to soul crush you on the inside or the outside. So there's lateral movement that's also gradually forward movement. As you can see right now, that is Smashalotopus trying to get her way through for 5 more points.
We have the pivot now being peeled off to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. Having a little bit of a quick conversation with their bench. And, of course, as they should, they're saying, just sit down. Don't question it. Just get yourself back into play as soon as you can. Because guess what? We are now at a three-point game. Boulder County, 136. Demolition City, 139. 13:40 to play.
11-point jam there for Boulder County. And nothing to be gained there from Demolition City. Like you said, it is a three-point game, but we do have a couple issues right now. Coco Crimajo and Sprint Tarantino, Shelby in Pain, Steffery for Demolition City, all within striking distance of foul outs. They have five apiece.
Well, you have to consider, you've got 13 minutes left. How long can you keep that up to not step over that line? You've already done it five times. Stepping over the Fast Girl Skate start line would be Godzilla number 82 in the black and Miss Fortune Cookie in the white. She right now has got the two wall, two waiting to assist. If she can get past, looks like a little bit of a incidental hit to the head. Nothing major, though. Good blocking still happening from the front of the pack. Brought to you by Demolition City as their jammer comes around. She is lead jammer, and that is Godzilla.
Going to the penalty box right now, 727. That's Jainsrus Jukes for Boulder County, notorious RED penalty box.
Godzilla looking to see which way she will be able to come in. She's only got two to get around, so nice assistance at the back of the pack, putting herself in the place she needs to
be. Ooh, a huge booty block, forcing Demolition City's jammer to the inside. And that was from the pivot, B-Dong Kadonk.
Again, jammer taking a moment to get back up. She's able to do so. That is Miss Fortune Cookie now from almost a lane position. Tries to get the sprint, can't get through. But we have a bit of a chase as Godzilla was able to get through on that pass, picking up 5 points, continue to build on their lead. Again, they are a little bit more risky as far as penalty trouble, so they need to build as much as they can in case they start losing skaters. Again, gets through, picks up 5 points.
And there was a star pass happening in there. And that is the star being transferred right now. And that is Catastrophebe who picked it up for Boulder County. And so there was a little bit of confusion in there beforehand because the star had been passed, but it was hidden in somebody's hands. A lot of time, that's a really fantastic strategy because nobody knows who's got the star unless you're looking at hands. And most of the time, as a blocker, you're not looking at hands. You're looking at the helmets and skates and hips.
As you should.
All right, the score now, Boulder County, 136. Demolition City, 149. Feisty one on the Fast Girl Skates jammer start line with Lickety Splint jamming for Demolition City.
We will see if she tries to take the inside lane, gets knocked down. Now she gets knocked out by the pivot. Catastrophebe pulls herself back, realizes she can't go any further. Makes it a little bit easier for her to come back in, but still has a lot of ground to make up as lead jammer is Feisty one.
That's B-Donk-a-Donk headed to the penalty box now for Demolition City. Another 5 points for Boulder County.
Now she's coming around, jammer again being recycled. Demolition City's jammer looking to see which way she can go. She gets knocked to then the outside, not having an easy run of it. Lickety Splint has been in this game quite a bit, but not so much in this position. It's got to get her head wrapped around that new aspect of the game as the jammer opposing her, Feisty one, up into the middle of the pack, has two more to get past.
And Feisty has the opportunity to not just tie the game here, but take the lead. Yep, hips and pass. It looks like hips in front of one. She just needs to get her hips in front of the other to take the lead right now.
Coco Crimajo and Bangs McCoy holding.
I believe she has taken the lead. Oh, slowly getting her hips around, which she does on the inside for five more points. And once again, we have another lead change. Boulder County, 151. Demolition City, 149.
As we see, everybody is out on the track.
That is a star pass happening right now for Demolition City. That is number 25, Lickety Splint, who still has it in her hand, though. And there's an illegal procedure call happening. That is being assessed, though, against Boulder County.
Yeah, Hershey Bad being sent to the notorious RED penalty box. Nice bit of work earlier from Bangs McCoy, who did a nice defensive block against Catastrophebe. Saw that she was going to come back and try and free her jammer. She was not able to do so, however, because of that fact.
24-point jam for Boulder County against a 2-point jam for Demolition City. So now another lead change with 9 minutes left in this game. Boulder County 160, Demolition City 151.
We said ever inching past each other. A little bit of a runaway. It seems as though Boulder County has kind of regrouped, taken a strategy, made it move. The question is, did Demolition City once again get a little panicky? Hopefully not. We're going to see what happens now with Steffery. She's out. Lead jammer.
Steffery also sitting on 5 penalties for Demolition City.
Smash a lot of puts, has the 3 wall to get past.
And we do still see great defense at the front from Demolition City as their jammers through for 5 more points. Another lead change, Bam Bam.
It almost seems like Steph Marie is jamming now because you saw the consequence of Lickety Splint. She hadn't jammed much. They had a loss. They're going to put and take the risk to put number 81 back out as she passes through yet again, picking up 5 more points for Demolition City. They are going to have a quick lead change here as they now go 1 point up at 161. Looking to see what the jammer can do. Smash a lot of puts on the side of White. Boulder County is looking to see.
No points on the board yet for Boulder County, but 10 points working on it.
That's because we've got right now the Jamstar in her hand of the pivot. We see Catastrophe just trying to get through the pack. Great awareness from Demolition City, realizing that it had been handed off, and now there is a big focus on the former, well, technically still pivot.
And Catastrophe looking for a line. Really the only thing she can do is fight through, and she does. She staggers through the inside, Bam.
Shelby in pain sent to Notorious RID penalty box. She was the pivot. She's now there on her 6th trip.
And that is an out of play being assessed to a blocker for Demolition City. Oh, finally through Catastrophe B. Looking exhausted, she puts on that jammer star.
It seems to take so much more effort, and all for naught as the jam comes to a conclusion. Check an update to our points. It looks like with 7 minutes left, we've got Boulder 160, Demolition 172.
So here's the kind of game we're looking at, right? Jam number 12 in this half, 24 points for Boulder County. Jam number 30 in this half, 21 points for Demolition City. They're able to hold each other scoreless with these huge point gains, and it's not tit for tat as easily as you think.
We had a helmet cover come flying out just a few moments ago. It looks like clarification as they had a pivot stripe on, but now the pivot is back in. She's got to be careful again. That is Shelby N. Payne, who is rejoining the fray. The lead jam is gone to Miss Fortune Cookie. Jammer, though, is through for Demolition City. We will see what Hertz Donut can do because she's just got to go for broke. 6 minutes left.
Hertz Donut found an outside line the size of a quarter to get through in order to clear that pack, but she did.
It's about roughly the size of a donut.
Hertz Donut.
Now get good pack speed. They realize that they've got to get away from the jammers. You don't have anyone with any real control happening. Right now, as they're setting up, we do have a little bit more on the benefit of Boulder County as they have the four wall at the front.
There is another star pass happening right now on behalf of Demolition City, and that is Shelby in pain, the pivot, putting on the jammer star now for Demolition City.
She's got to be careful, though. She's got 6 trips, so they've got to play smart. They'll switch her out if they need to. 5.5 minutes to go. Still 12-point game as both of these jammers looking to get any movement forward points. Nice, slow power stop from both sides of the track.
And MF Cookie really trying to get that destruction called, and there is a no pack called that worked in her favor. She is going to get a low block penalty. No, I'm sorry. It is her opposing blocker that is going to get it. That is a 5-point pass, a 4-point pass for Boulder County.
4 points, though, also for Demolition City. Looking to see now. It's just turned into a bit of a foot race. Nope, jammer gets in. We'll see if any more points. It looks like 4 for Boulder County, 2 for Demolition City. So close that gap a little bit. Still, the way we've seen this game go, lots of time to make one more of those big plays, and I think that's what it may boil down to. Is there one more big play in the bag for Boulder County?
10 points separate these teams. Boulder County, 168. Demolition City, 178. Just 4.5 minutes left in this period. We do have a pack advantage for Boulder County, though.
So, whistle underway. Fast Girl Skate start line is going to show us who will be first sprinting, Tarantino or Feist E1. Sprinting Tarantino it is.
Right behind her, though, Feist E1. Sprinting Tarantino also sitting on 5 penalties, so she is going to want to be careful here.
That Feisty one has only gone twice, but she's put up 94 points. So definitely the power jammer for her team. Even though she heard whistle, she still pushed through as hard as she could, picking up 3, neutralizing the majority of the points gained by Demolition City as they picked up 4.
So that was a really interesting offensive move there from Bedonkadonk, number 00, Demolition City. There was a 4-wall of Boulder County blockers, and she just kind of went over and she put her knee between them. She just kind of like poked her knee through, and that helped to cause enough chaos and room to give her jammer a little bit of help. But now we have a pack advantage for Demolition City again, 182 to Boulder's 171.
As we're watching our jammers move forward, got a little bit of a break for Godzilla in the black. She now is through as lead jammer. Not as much luck, though, for Meg My Day, who's had a little bit of a tough one through here. She's had some success, but not nearly as much as her teammates, where right now, again,
that is going to be a curse. Cutting the track call for Meg My Day. She's not happy about that, but she did think that she made it through cleanly on the inside line there.
She did indeed. You could see her shake her head just a little bit of a moment, but she is at the Notorious RID penalty box with 2:45 left to go. 11 points in favor. Demolition City also have the power jam right now. They're going to add 5 to that.
So we've got 4-on-4 defensively here.
Again, looks like just kind of standing. Oh, a double. Passive goes aggressive to try to break it up. But again, I think almost Boulder County saw that one coming. Not a surprise. Moved forward out of the range, really, of Demolition City, making it an easier pass. Now we've got Demolition City jammer recycling. Jammer, though, is back in for Boulder County right up in the middle. Got a 3-wall. Looks like no 4 to get past.
This is 5 points so far in this pass for Demolition City. None for Boulder County.
Indeed it is. It's 3 blockers at the back of the pack trying to contain Godzilla. We have the pivot standing in the penalty box. She should be back out shortly. That short stack. She's got 5 trips, though.
Pushing hard against those one-on-one defenders. Meg My Day finally able to make it through for her initial pass. Bam.
Short stack gets back just in time, but Godzilla decides to call it instead as she sees Jammer coming back around. Meg My Day looking decidedly winded. We have a timeout called by the team that has a few left.
This is the time to do it. That is the last timeout for Boulder County, but this is appropriately placed. There's 20 points that separate them in Demolition City. Boulder County 171, Demolition 191. With a minute and 26 seconds left in this game, we would like to take the opportunity to thank S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad. What?
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 What? S1 Helmets, what?
Go to S1Helmets.com. That's S, the number one, Helmets, plural, .com. So,
20 points.
Yes, tit for tat, both of these teams. We had talked about each of these teams trading gigantic jams, where we had scoreless jams for Boulder County, we had big jams for Demolition City. Where we had big jams for Boulder County, we had scoreless jams for Demolition City. The last 3 jams have pretty much been tit for tat. With the exception of the last jam, Boulder County scored no points on that last trip through the track.
Well, a minute 26 left in this period. That's a questionable amount of time if you can get 2 jams in. You can, of course, get through quickly, get that push, but a lot is going to be resting on the shoulders of the jammer, who, of course, has been the most successful feisty one for Boulder County, but she's going up against Sephiri, who's been very successful getting that lead as well. So pushing. Benefit right now, I have to say, goes to Sephiri just for the simple fact that she's got 3 to pass and she's farther along in the track.
And there is that no pack call, even though she is recycled, and beautiful work by Boulder County still trying to recycle her in the back. But she makes it through, although she is not lead. There is a no pass, no penalty call.
I think that was great, great play from number 11 for Boulder County. That was Trixie Von Tees. Read it, saw it, got herself in position, got the bump. Her skate out went as well, or it would have been a cut. So it's unfortunate, but nice maneuvering to make sure that it didn't go specifically in favor. It looks like right now, just content to wait. Just content to stop for a moment was Sephiri.
Oh, there is going to be a star pass, and she's going to try to hand that over, and it does look to be successful to number 25, Lickety Splint.
Interesting. We've got Boulder County. Feisty one has no opportunity or no need to stop this because the period has run down. They don't have any timeouts, any reviews. At this point, Unfortunately, even though she's lead, it was under the 30 seconds by the time it was established. This jam is just going to go pretty much until she decides to stop it or until it's concluded. And that means she's got to make up that difference of about 16 points to tie.
She's going for broke right now. There is going to be a track cutting
call. But maybe with 24 seconds, I don't know if she can get four passes in, though. But she's got 11 to make.
That is another 5 points for Boulder County coming in on the power jam. One more time, Bam. And there is going to be a call, though. That is a whistle, and it appears to be against Boulder County's jammer. That is going to be a low block, and but that is the end of the game.
That was the time anyway, though. Time had run down.
So that last jam was a 12-point jam for Boulder County, 3 points for Demolition City, but just not enough for Boulder County to close that gap. The final score here, 180, well, the unofficial final, I should say, 183 for Boulder County to Demolition City's 194. An 11-point game, all of these games this weekend.
And again, not as dramatic upset, but a slight one. I believe there's about a two slots down. Demolition City came in behind Boulder County. If I'm not mistaken, they are 6 and 8 respectively. Feel free to correct me on that by talking hashtag talk to WFTDA. But I think it's the way this weekend has gone. Upsets by little margins. And I think that's what really conceivably makes for some of the best roller derby.
And that is the final score. Boulder County 183 to Demolition City's 194. This means that Demolition City will advance to play Queen City in game 11 at 6 o'clock this evening. And they're going to battle it out for fifth place. Boulder, of course, moves on as well. They are going to play later on in the weekend as well in Game 13, and they will play the loser of Game 7, who was Grand Raggedy.
I hope you wrote that down, because I'm not going to remember all that. That's why I wrote it all down. This beautiful cheat sheet. If you're watching at home, write it down. You're going to have a good opportunity throughout the rest of the weekend here at the International 2014 WFTDA Division II Playoff, brought to you in Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario, Canada, in part by the Tri-City Roller Girls and, of course, the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. We thank you for joining us, for listening, or for watching.
So, of course, Demolition City comes into this tournament the number 8 seed. They have the opportunity to advance for 5th place in this tournament. Boulder is playing for 9th place. So they came into this tournament, Boulder County did, at the number 6 seed. So they will definitely move down no matter what. But Demolition City has the opportunity to make up for that 3-point loss against Bear City, the first game out in this tournament. Speaking of Bear City, they are coming up next in what is touted as the game of the day for some.
Yeah, I was going to say for some.
Rideau, of course, will be taking on Rideau Valley, will be taking on Gold Coast, which will be the game of the day for others.
So please stick around. We know that you will. My name is Bam Bam.
I'm Double H. You're watching WFTDA.TV. Do not walk away from your computer, your laptop, your mobile device, because the next game is going to be insane, like all of the action here from Kitchener-Waterloo. So on behalf of WFTDA.TV, we'll see you right back here in just a few minutes.
Spankin' and Trish the Dish here to tell you about Sin City Skates. Sin City Skates began in our living room in 2005 and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot warehouse and showroom where we stock everything for derby. If it's derby related, we probably have it. Need help? With a combined on-track derby experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell and we know the difference between facts and our opinions. We're always happy to share both with you to help you make the right decisions. So call us. SinCitySkates.com.
This was definitely a proud moment for me, wearing the black, white, and red. It's such a bold uniform, first of all. It's just Texas right across. That's a team you skate out onto that track, and there's just no guessing who you are. You just feel the team. It feels very much like the kind of thing you want to wear out into battle, and it's really great. I like it. I'm Fifi Nominon with the Texas Roller Girls Texecutioners, and S1 is part of my uniform. We'll be right back.
watching WFTDA.tv.